Greetings and maximum respect. I'm Native Wayne Jobson, and my mission here is to try and capture the magic that I experienced when I first saw and heard the brilliance of Sublime. Greatness is rare in modern music, and very few bands have created their own unique sound. A great band is defined by people saying, so-and-so sounds like the Beatles, or that one sounds like Radiohead. One such genre-defining band is Sublime. There are many imitators, but they're all clones to the throne created by master maestro Bradley Nowell. This is what Dave Navarro of the Red Hot Chili Peppers and Jane's Addiction had to say.
Sublime was just one of those bands that was just totally captivating, and the singer just had an incredible spirit about him, but he also captured the truth of today and what's going on in the streets, and there was a darkness that was relatable. So for me, when I checked out Sublime, you know, I got like a real nice like reggae vibe, but then I also got like some serious issues that I could personally relate with that weren't necessarily coming out of Jamaica. They were coming out of the streets of LA. It was, you know, it was badass, dude. I love those guys.
Amazing Sublime with Foolish Fool. The band No Doubt eventually became big fans of Sublime, and they did many shows together. Tony Canal from No Doubt told us about the first time he ever heard Sublime.
Wow, the first time I heard Sublime, we were playing a show, I think it was the early 90s, maybe 1990 or 91, and we're playing a club up in Hollywood, and somebody at the club gave me a demo tape and said, you should check this band out. We listened to it on the way home, Gwen and I in the car, and it just became our favorite tape to listen to. And we listened to it so much, we eventually broke it. Like, the cassette eventually snapped because we just listened to it so much, and it had, like, the early demos. We loved it. We loved it so much we broke the tape.
Gwen Stefani from No Doubt. Say what's up, all right?
Hi. Gosh, Bradley, you look so cute.
I'm prosperous.
Yum, yum.
Just a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. Every day I love her just a little bit more, and she loves me the same.
Every day I love her just a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. Every day I love her just a little bit more, and she loves me the same.
So baby, if you wanna get high,
baby, if you wanna get low,
it makes no sense at all.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Come just a little bit more, feeling like a dog in all the yard. It's just how we are.
And every day I wonder if it's over when I wake up real loud. Put your hands on your brain, down the wall.
You see it's not that I can't believe you. And if you say it's
twice, then I try to the same view.
I'm aware of the high and the low. I've been waiting for you in the middle, but I just like control. Now please, if you want to get low,
oh, baby, if you want to get out,
next up, dance it all.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sublime influenced the whole generation of musicians, including No Doubt, Jack Johnson, 311, Sugar Ray, Gwen Stefani, Snoop Dogg, and Michael Franti and Spearhead, to name a few. Here's Michael Franti's thoughts on Sublime.
Sublime kind of made it cool to care, you know, and there was a lot of bands at the time who were coming out of a similar sort of scene where they're playing punk music, but it was very negatively inspired, you know, and then also Sublime was touching on dub, touching on roots, touching on dancehall a little bit, you know, and they were combining that with that kind of do-it-yourself attitude of punk music, you know, and I think that that's why they touched a lot of people, you know, why that music went beyond just the small little punk clubs to being internationally loved.
I'm a parasite, creep and crawl, I step into the night. Two pints of booze, tell me, are you bad fish too? Are you bad fish too? But I ain't got no for him. Lord knows I'm weak, and would somebody get me up with this free? Maybe you're a big blue whale, grab the reef over on the diving bell, and I swim and I fish I'd never heard. Water's too polluted now with a germ, and I dive deep when it's 10 feet overhead. Grab the reef underneath my bed, underneath my bed, but I ain't got no quarrels with joy. Ain't got no time to get high. Lord knows I'm a weak. Woo!
And won't somebody give me half of this?
Truly wicked song, Bad Fish, showing the genius of Bradley Noel. Here's Bradley describing how he created his sound.
I'm Bradley. Sing. It was punk rock from the get-go. Yeah. That's what we were all into. And then when I was up at Santa Cruz, started getting into different, just hardcore dancehall kind of stuff, and brought it back down here. And well, the thing we had going for us is just that we had a new style. Like what it was, the way it all started too was with the ska music. When we got into that, and it just changed my life, you know. And then it's the same thing as punk, except instead of that distortion guitar, it's that upbeat, and the reggae is just the halftime ska. It just all seemed just a logical progression to put it all together like that. We had something special, so we went out there. Sure, we were playing in front of the sound guy and the cocktail waitress for a lot of shows, but every show we had, we always met friends. And the next time we came through, you know, tapes had been duped all over the place, and came back, and there was people there, you know? Yeah. And it was a trip. It kept coming through. That's a do-it-yourself ethos right there. That's that momentum. But the thing is, you got to have the product, you know? And we really had something going on. You could just tell because people were so nice. Yeah, there is a network. There's an underground out there. It's pretty, yeah, pretty cool. That's what we came up on, just that. Kind of a grassroots. I mean, it's funny how the way the bands we fit in with is, you know, we could play with a hardcore band or a ska band, a reggae band, you know what I mean? I do the lyrics. I do like the melody and the style-y, whatever, and say it to them. But these guys, they know me and what I've been doing, and just kind of developed their own view about the reggae and the ska and everything. It's good music to be influenced from. I mean, that dance hall stuff like that, you know what I mean? Eric and Bud, yeah, incredible rhythm section, you know. They're like, drum and bass is the backbone of the whole music, of the whole reggae trip. For punk, car, whatever, for that matter. You know what I mean? It's a collaboration. There's three of our different styles coming. You got different approaches at the music. It's a trip.
One, two, booyah! My posse, his name was Jim. He is this hippie from Capistrano. And everywhere he go, yes, he bring me those things. And if you wanna party, say it go like this. He say, I got a little mushroom, I'll be back. And if I wanna smoke it, you will make you feel alright. We gotta, but you know, you smoke that shit, you don't rhyme on time. My brain, a lot of things, a lot like it's not insane. I like my dick, got my eyes inside. And if I soul fucking let me feel alright, I got the green herbs kicking by my bed. And in the morning, gonna go to my head. If I start to feel like I'm pit, you know what? I feel like I got my head to the curb. Unless I got a little bitty bag of earth. And if I got the green, gonna make a scene. I'm gonna smoke it all over. You know what? Because Jimmy once told me, gotta be hard smoking, man. Told me, smoke as much green pot as you can. Then one day, I met a man who came to me and said, hard work good, hard work fine, but never trust a deadhead, yeah.
One of reggae's all-time classics, Smoke Two Joints, done by Sublime. And Mark McGrath from Sugar Ray was a big fan of Sublime, and this is what he had to say.
You know, I think Sublime had the incredible tenacity to really put hip-hop, punk rock, and reggae together and have it make sense. You know, that's a real slippery slope, and I know because our band has done that and failed miserably at it. But Sublime was sort of the standard bearer of how to do that with, you know, Bradley's voice. You know, it's Dennis Brown meets Jacob Miller and everything great about those voices through the eyes of a kid growing up in the suburb of Long Beach who was listening to Black Flag but also had Straight Outta Compton on a CD player. You know, when all those elements come together, it's very hard to synthesize that into one sound and make it work, but I'll be damned if Sublime didn't do that the best. And certainly Bradley as a songwriter was amazing, you know. Of course, with that sort of genius comes, you know, all the unpredictability. You know, unfortunately, one of the Sublime shows I went to before they really blew up, they didn't make the gig. You know what I mean? So I think a lot of people had that experience a few times. I think they're supposed to play the Whiskey like in like 94 or something. And, you know, being an Orange County guy, we had gotten signed to Atlantic and, you know, they were from Long Beach and they were getting their heat and they were getting signed. And Dave Quackenbush from the Vandals is like, you gotta go see Sublime. So I went to the Whiskey and I guess they didn't show up that night, but, be it far for me because I was wasted too. I wouldn't have remembered. But, you know, I was like, boy, these guys are doing something different. And then I remember sitting in my backyard in Los Angeles and I heard Radley's voice. I mean, the soul in that kid, you know, it was incredible. And just hearing that was music to my ears. And I was like, this is everything I ever wanted to do and wanted to be. You know what I mean? The mix of reggae, the hip hop, the punk, and with the attitude and the lyrics. And, you know, the lyrics weren't anything that weren't, you know, totally inherent to him and what he did. And he lived these lyrics, you know? And so him maybe saying, I'll bust a cap. So he's seen that in Long Beach. You know what I mean? Where it might have been fraudulent from other people's. It was just, that was a moment to me that just, I went, wow, this is everything I want to do. And Sugar Ray, I mean, I wouldn't be sitting here if it wasn't for some Lime or Bradley or the genius that is the entire band.
Annie's 2 years old and tomorrow she'll be a whore. Nobody ever told us the wrong way. Don't be afraid with the quickness you get laid. For your family get paid, baby, it's the wrong way. Don't be afraid if it's time to live. I'm gonna make it hard to live. Your two brown eyes are leaking like a sieve. But I still rule Jamaica and never won't live. 2 years old and tomorrow she'll be a whore. Nobody ever told it's the wrong way. Don't be afraid for the quickness you get paid. For your family get laid, baby, it's the wrong way. To be fun if it's time to live. Still rule Jamaica, but won't know. Music and sound make the pit go around. He said, will if I make it and never won't give. He's 2 years old, tomorrow she'll be a whore. Nobody ever told it's the wrong way. Don't be afraid, the quickness you'll get laid. Your family get paid, it's the wrong way. Take it off, hard to live. I'm gonna make it hard to live. Eyes leaking like a tear. I do rule Jamaica and never won't give. Don't be afraid, the quickness you get laid. The family gets paid, but it's the wrong way. Make it all hard to live.
And we'll be right back to talk to Sublime.